Hello friends, today we will going to discuss the one more topic in communication, that is agriculture journalism. See, journalism is very, very important. We all know that many of the information is known to us through these medias. So the how the information is flowing to this media and how this media is influencing on dissemination of agriculture technology is mainly depends upon the journalism, what they are doing. Today we will going to discuss about the different aspects of the journalism. Now we will see what is journalism. The journalism is systematic and reliable dissemination of public information, public opinion, public entertainment by modern mass media of communication. That is nothing but the journalism acts as a bridge in which they'll collect the information which is happening around us, and they are formatting it in a systematic way, which could be reliable and which could be accepted by the people and useful to the people, such that it has to be modified and disseminated to the public in terms of public information, or maybe in terms of opinion, or in terms of entertainment by using different mass media channels. The important journalism channels are the mass media channels which is used for dissemination of information through journalism are, the first one is the newspaper and the periodicals. As we know that we are having different types of newspaper, daily, weekly, monthly, fortnightly, even evening newspaper, regional newspaper, national newspaper, like that we are getting so many newspapers and the periodicals. The periodicals may be the magazines like Taranga, Sudha, India Today, Week. Even with respect to agriculture also, so many periodicals are there. So like this, they are approaching to the public through this newspaper and the periodicals. And the next mass media which is used for dissemination of information is radio. See, radio is the basic unit through which the people used to get the information, and we can cover large number of population in a short period of time through this radio. And the next one is the television. The most attractive and acceptable and majority of the people using this media is the television, where you can see and hear both. So that's why, which is more acceptable and more used by the public for getting the information through this. And the next one is the films. So we have seen a lot of films, maybe short films, documentary, so many things which is used to educate the people or give the information with respect to several aspects. And the next one is advertising. The advertising is the one more means through which the information is disseminated through journalists or for through this journalism. These are the major five media through which the information is disseminated to the public for effective utilization or to get the information what is happening around that. Now we will see what is the first thing we should know, that who is responsible for initiating this journalism. The Joseph Pulitzer, who is called as the father of journalism, he is the one who started the first newspaper in New Zealand, and afterwards everything was popularized in different parts. When we come to India, this is James August Hickey. He is from East India Company. He is mainly responsible for starting the journalism activity in India by starting the first paper, that is Bengal Gazette, which is popularly called as Hickey's Bengal Gazette, and which was started. Afterwards, the Madras, they have come out with the Madras periodicals has come, which is published through Madras. Like that, many things has come in a journalism. Now we will see what are the importance of journalism. The first thing is it could be capable of reaching the widespread audience in a short period of time. I have told the major advantage of this or the importance of journalism is we can disseminate the information to a large number of people in a short period of time without hampering the information or without disseminating the actual meaning of the information to the public. And the next one is the interactive information system made possible through this computer technology. That is nothing but by using this new information technology, the information may be made interactive, like the phone-in programs or panel discussion. And nowadays, there may be a live channel will be there where you can give a comment or you can pass the comment, everything will be done. And here, This journalism is very important to keep the people informed about what is happening around them and what are the duties they have to perform very adequately, efficiently. That will help them to develop in a different social field. So for that, the information is disseminated through this journalism or through this media. And journalism can able to convey the national policies to the public in one way, and they can be informed about what is happening in a government or maybe at the state level or a central level. And based that means they act as a bridge in which they used to give what is the policies or the activities taken up at the government level, maybe at the central, local or the regional level. And the same way, they will use to give a feedback based on the public needs and requirement to the government, where they can take up some of the policy issues or they can take up some of the measures to fulfill the requirement of this audience. And the next thing is, this helps to bring to the notice of the government about the public reaction to the government policies and the decision. This you could see in the TV, radio or the newspaper once the budget, the speech is over. When the budget is put forth, next day you can see in the media that what is the public opinion about the budget? What are the strong points? What are the weak points? Where it is advantageous? Where it is not helpful for the public. Everything feedback is given based on the policy decisions taken up by the government for the benefit of the people. Whether it is useful or not will be given by these media or through this journalism. What are the rules to be followed by the journalist when they want to be a good journalist, and what are the rules they have to follow? The first rules they have to follow is they must have the complete knowledge about the field. That means they should be technically sound. Anybody cannot become a journalist. They must have a basic knowledge about the principles or the ethics of journalism. Then only they can able to do a good journalism. And they should look for the ideas. We cannot present each and everything as an important news or each and everything as very important and as an important thing. See, they should look for the idea, which should be presented as a good information for the public. And once they look to the idea, they should develop the idea also. See, the information as it is cannot be presented to the public through mass media. It has to be modified based on the requirement of the people. The idea has to be modified. And always there should be unbiased mind. I should not be biased. I should not favor a particular group of people or a particular person. Whenever I am presenting the information, I should be unbiased and consider each and everybody as equal. And always you should write in such a way that it should be clear and understandable. Whenever you are writing for the public or presenting in the media, it should be very clear. It should not be ambiguous and it should not give meaning to different meaning to the different people. So it should be very clear. And the next thing is they should know about the audience. That means whenever I am presenting information, to whom I am presenting, whether it is for the kids, whether it is for the old age people, whether it is for the women, youth, to whom I am presenting, based on that, I have to present the information based on the requirement of the people. And it should be, one should write with a purpose. For what I am writing, whether to bring an awareness among the people, to give a knowledge about what is happening around that, or whether to change their attitude, or whether to give an opinion, or to help them to develop an opinion. So you must have a purpose for which you are writing. Based on purpose, you have to present your information. And the next thing is, information should be timely. Always give the information based on the requirement of the people. It should be need-based and timely. See, for example, when it is a time of education or when there is admission time, you should give the information with respect to the education, what they can take up in a higher education, what they can carry out, and how they can make up their career, all these things. When it is the time of health management in a summer season or a winter season, you should give information based on how you could able to manage your health in a summer or maybe in a winter. That has to be considered. And you always give attention toward an event or an occasion. That means when you are writing some information about an event or an occasion, you should give complete attention on that, such that you should not be biased, you should not miss any important point, or you should not give wrong information in your journalism. And always maintain your credibility. Don't give unfactual ideas or something which is non-believable. which should not be supported with something which is in a reality. So always maintain your trustworthiness and have a potentiality. If anybody thinks about you, they should see that you are highly potential and you are credible. Whatever you say could be trusted and could be taken for consideration. That should be there as a journalist. And you must have a better communication skill. Without a communication skill, you cannot convey the message very efficiently and very effectively to the audience. You should consider each and everybody's requirement, potentiality. Based on that, you have to communicate with respect to your communication skills. Now we will come to the next topic. One of the subtopic in a journalism is agriculture journalism. Here, the information with respect to agriculture will be given by the journalist. It is not with respect to general information. So now we will see what is agriculture journalism. The agriculture journalism is nothing but a timely reporting, editing of the words and photographs of agricultural news and information for the newspaper, magazines, radio, and television. It is, in a short term, we can say that it is a collection and editing of the information which is of current interest with respect to agriculture for the presentation through mass media for news media. Mass media may be a magazine, newspaper, radio, television, whatever it may be. So here we are collecting the information with respect to agriculture, which is of current interest, and we will edit it with respect to the media in which I am presenting or in a presentable form, and it will be presented in a different news medias as it in terms of news. So this is what is called as a agriculture journalism. Now we will see some of the important agriculture journals. The Kethi, which is the first farm magazine published in India in it back maybe in 1914 by ICR. Next it is followed by Indian Farming, which was published in 1940, and Indian Horticulture in 1956. And Palpul, it is a regional language, and Kethi is also in a Hindi language, which was published in 1979. Whereas Krishi Sudhar is a first periodical which was published by ICR in 1940. Now it is not there, but all other magazines are coming out with a different name, and now still it is going on. And these are the some of the journals and periodicals which are initially published in a agriculture field. But now we could able to find lot of journals with respect to agriculture from a different publishers and from different publishing agencies. Now we will see what are the scope of agriculture journalism. The first thing is it helps in providing the additional information, supplementary information, or change in information and comparative information will be given to us on timely basis. See, the journalism helps us to update ourselves, keep our information up to date by knowing about the changed information or some comparative information or supplementary information, which helps in developing our knowledge horizon and where we can able to become a competitive with respect to our information. And here the information will be presented in a sequential form. So it could be easily understood, and always it is used to be in a logical way. And the information is usually used to be in a timely nature. Whenever we are telling about the journalism, always the information is presented in a timely basis rather than on untimely basis. So if you come to India, Dr. Rajaram Mohan Roy, he is called as a father of journalism in India, who helped us to start the information and all those things. And now we will see some of the important characteristics of agriculture journalism. See, whenever we are presenting the information in agriculture journalism, it should be factual. Factual means it should be fact, and it has to have some support. Then only you can present, because we are presenting here with the technical information. So it should be supported with the real fact or the information. And the next one is always present the information in a step-by-step manner. That means arrange the information in a logical way, organize in a such a way that it should be easily understood based on step-by-step information. And next thing is the agriculture journalism should be on timely basis. Give the information on timely basis. For example, if it is the sowing season, give information with respect to sowing, seeds availability, spacing, seedbed preparation, all those things. If it is the time of plant protection, give some information about some of the important insects, pests, diseases, and how it could be managed through biological means, chemical means, cultural means. All these things could be given on timely basis. And always you should present the information in an informal style of writing. Don't use too much technical term. The technical way, the scientific way of writing should not be there. Always you should follow the informal way, because the main reader or the recipient of our information is the farmers. So the farmers could be able to understand the information in a local language, in a local terms, has to be used and written in an informal style. And always you have to have a definite source of information. Don't write the information based on your imagination or somebody has told. Gossip cannot be an information in agriculture journalism. Always it has to be presented in a with a definite source of information. And always you have to present the information in such a way that it should help them to change their attitude. Attitude change is nothing but whenever I am presenting the information about a particular technology, that must help them to change their opinion, and the technology should be adopted by the farmers in a real way. That means the changing the attitude of the people, they must be ready to accept the technology, whichever the presented in a journalism or in a agriculture journalism. Now we will see some of the basic principles of rural journalism or agriculture journalism. The first thing is you must use a simple language. As I have already told, the one of the important recipient of our message is the farmer. Farmer cannot understand the technical terms, and always you have to use the common words or the local words which could be used regularly, and always present your information in a simple words, in a short and a simple sentences. And the next thing is structure and arrangement of the information should be clear. That means you have to present the idea in a logical way, in an order way, and it has to clearly distinguish between the main important idea and other associated information. So you have to concentrate on the basic information, then you can look after the side issues or the side information. And the next thing is you have to make the main point very briefly. That means when we are telling about the journalism, the attention ability of the people is very less, maybe 10 to 15 minutes. So always you present the ideas or the main issues in a clear and direct words, in a short sentence or in a short way. Don't use unnecessary words. Don't make your unnecessary beating around the bush thing or make it flowery. All those things should not be there. You present to the point, important points in a short sentence, in a short format. And the next thing is keep the important information at the top. See, always you are write up in such a way that it has to follow the inverted pyramid shape. That means important point has to come at the top, because always the people are having a habit of reading only two or five sentences, which is there in the first. So always keep the important sentences or the important point at the top such that they can get the information immediately. Always use the lively pictures or the photographs. See, always a picture is equal to 1,000 words. So always you have to use the pictures to support your wordings, and these pictures should be simple, and always you have to give a title for each and every pictures which is presented in your article. And the next one is prepare a stimulating write-up. That means you have to write in such a way that it has to follow the ABC principle. That is accurate, it should be brief, and it should be clear. That means the fundamentals of good presentation of the information has to be followed, such that it has to motivate or stimulate the audience to go through the article or read the information and get the information very effectively and efficiently. What are the importance of agriculture journalism? The main importance of agriculture journalism is it helps in teaching the farmers about the different farm activities. Not only farmers, even farm leaders, extension workers, helps them to motivate them and put the recommendation into their day-to-day work. That means they are updating about the new happenings happening around the in the agriculture field for all the stakeholders of the agriculture. And one more thing is it helps in providing the feedback to the researcher. The journalism can able to give feedback to the researcher about what is happening in actually farmers' field, what they actually need, what has to be conducted in a research such that it should able to fulfill the needs of the farming community. And it forms the basis for future research. Based on these feedback, the researcher can take up the future research. And here, this journalism helps us in giving the immediate information for the farmers within a short period of time. For example, the weather forecasting, market information could be given through these mass medias or through this journalism. And these journalists could able to immunize the mass opinion or the public opinion. For example, by giving the information, they can immunize or they can motivate the people to, by collecting the mass opinion or the public opinion about a particular technology or about a particular issues. What are the important functions of a journalism? The first function is the news function. The news function means here we are going to give the information or the news, what is happening around us. That means the news aspects. The second one is the opinion function. That is, for example, we don't know importantly about what is happening. For example, the corona. Nowadays, the pandemic is going on and everybody is don't know what is happening in a corona, whether really that much people are dying, whether the facilities are not there or oxygen is not there. This media is giving us the information to develop our opinion about a particular topic. That is what is the opinion function. Based on giving the information or giving detailed information or the positivity and negativity of a particular situation or the particular information helps us to develop a opinion about a particular individual or about a particular information. And the next one is the entertainment function. That means they are entertaining us with the different aspects, maybe through serials, films, short films, advertisement, everything. That means they used to give some of the human interest information, news stories, everything will be given for the entertainment. Now we will see some of the important sources of news. These are the some of the important sources of the news. That is the result demonstration, sometimes the research station, research publications, that is maybe the annuals, periodicals, Krishi Mela, exhibition, even the farmers field, agriculture and allied departments, agriculture financial institution, all these things, the developmental department, input agencies, even agriculture universities, KVKs, marketing committee, farmers association and the clubs, and sometimes the electricity, irrigation and NGOs. These are acts as the sources of news for us. From the, all these areas, we are going to get the information or the source of the news. But many times what happens, the event itself can become a news, or sometimes the situation or the circumstances may act as a news for us, which is maybe a fact or sometimes it may be a rumor. Now we will see what are the important things are the journalist when they are writing, the basic things they have to follow when they are going for a writing. The first thing is why of writing. When I am writing something for a journal or for a TV or as a journalist, I should know why I am writing. What is the purpose behind it? What for what I am writing? Whether to give information to the audience, whether to change their attitude, whether to create an awareness, or whether to change their perceiveness. So these things should be kept in mind when I am going for writing. And the next one is to whom I am writing. To whom I am writing, whether it is for a farmer, whether it is for a age-old people, whether it is for the youth, whether it is for the woman, or whether it is on for a educational institutions. To whom I am writing, based on that, my write-up should be like that. The way in which I am writing for the farmer may not be same as the way in which I am writing for a kid. And the next thing is what I am writing. See, for what I am writing, whether it is on a technology, whether it is a opinion building, whether it is for the entertainment, or whether I am presenting some fact. For what I am writing, that is also important. Where of writing? Where I am writing, whether it is for the newspaper, whether it is for the periodicals, whether it is a editorial section, whether it is a short communication, whether it is a full article, whether it is going for a radio, as an interview, as a discussion forum, all these things is also plays an important role. When I am writing, that is the timeliness of writing. When I am writing, whether it is for a summer season, whether it is a winter season, for about the health management, whether I am writing for the health management, that is what is very important when I am writing. How I am writing, what way I am writing, whether it is a technical article, whether it is a feature article, news article, informal presentation, story writing, discussion forum. So these six important things are the question has to be answered by a journalist when they go for writing. So, but whatever you write, that should be brief, specific, accurate, and it should be convincing. Thank you so much for listening about the journalism. I hope you have understood being a basic journalist, what are the things has to be followed by a people. Thank you so much.